Welcome to Watch Therefore, or Watching for Our King, our Savior, Messiah Jesus. He told us to watch therefore and be ready, for you don't know the hour of the coming of the Son of Man. Dove Schwartz here at the Sea of Galilee, watching for our Savior to come in the clouds. His word says we're to be looking for the blessed hope and glorious appearing of our great God and Savior, Jesus Christ. So thankful for this time we have together. I think it's important to start our time off. We're going to go through the Word of God. I think it's important to start our time off with a word of prayer. Oh, Father in heaven, thank you for your Word. Your Word tells us that faith comes by hearing and hearing by the Word of God. Strengthen our faith so we can be pleasing to you today. Bless our viewers, Lord Jesus. Amen. The Apostle Paul in the first century, he's writing to the Roman born-again believers in Messiah Jesus. He wants to come see them. Yet there's something he has to do first, and he writes about that in Romans 15:25. But now I'm going to Jerusalem to minister to the saints, for it pleased those from Macedonia and Achaia to make a certain contribution for the poor among the saints who are in Jerusalem. It pleased them indeed, and they are their debtors, for the Gentiles have been partakers of their spiritual things. Their duty is also to minister to them in material things. Wow. This passage is one of our foundational scriptures for our ministry, blessing Israeli believers. In the next few minutes, you should better understand why we have this ministry. And I pray the Lord puts on your heart why it's so important to partner with such kingdom effort. Now, Paul says he's going to Jerusalem to minister to the born-again believers in Jerusalem. And he says it pleased those from the predominantly Gentile churches in the nations to make a contribution for the poor among the believers who are in Jerusalem, who are in Israel, the believers. And he says the reason is that they have a spiritual debt to the Jewish believers in Jesus in Israel. He says, because the Gentiles have been partakers of their spiritual things. The gospel, the covenants from Abraham onward, even the Messiah, Jesus, comes from the Jewish people. Right? And that's what he's talking about here. The reason you have heard the gospel, the reason you have the Bible, comes from the Jewish people. Yes? And you find this in Romans chapter 3 in the first few verses, in Romans chapter 9 at the beginning there as well, and many other places in the Bible, and again, the Bible written by the Jewish people. And so, that responsibility they took very seriously in Achaia and Macedonia, specific churches there. And he says it's their duty to minister to them material things. The cost of living is very high in Israel today. Oh, it's by American standards, even kind of you would think ridiculous. Think of this. A gallon of gas in Israel is about $6.50. And I'm going to mention that and some other things in the next segment. We have a special guest that's going to be with us on the program today. So anyhow, this ministry of the Apostle Paul is apostolic because it's the Apostle Paul. These writings are apostolic. And the ministry we have, Blessing Israeli Believers, is an apostolic ministry because of that. Right? It's not that I claim to be an apostle. It's that it's an apostolic ministry because it's following in the footsteps in the writings of the Apostle Paul and his ways and his actions and his efforts. Yes? This ministry, Blessing Israeli Believers, is prophetic. Not because we call ourselves prophets like Isaiah. Not that there's not prophets in the body of Messiah today. There certainly are. But not like Isaiah and not like Ezekiel. No, this ministry is prophetic because it's in the context of the Jewish people being back in the land, the Jewish believers being back in the land. I'll talk more about that in a moment. It's end times because it's in the context of the coming of Messiah Jesus. The believers being in the land today are a sign that Messiah Jesus is coming. What do I mean? And this ties in with where we can all participate together in this exciting apostolic, prophetic, end times ministry. You see, the Apostle Paul did this in the first century. He as a Jewish believer, would come out from Israel with the gospel, go out to the nations planting churches, then go back to Israel for the different feasts and holidays. You see that in the book of Acts. And so he speaks of the Jewish believers and ministering to them and the responsibility of the nations to do so. Then in 70 AD and then later on in like 133 to 135 AD, the Jewish people were cast out of the land, the believers along with them, cast out of the land of Israel and have been scattered among the nations, right? And Israel became desolate, where it became a desert where it was dry and a malaria swamp where there was water. And it became very desolate. Now, there was a handful of Jewish people, a contingency of Jewish people that have been in Israel down through the centuries, but just a handful, right? And so this ministry basically went out of existence. This ministry that Paul was doing, taking a collection, a financial collection for the believers in Jerusalem, was out of existence. And now, after around 1900 years, it's back. It's back. What am I saying? I'm saying now there are Israeli believers, and we can do what Paul did. We can do that. That is a sign of what kind of generation this is, that Messiah Jesus is coming. Now, I could go into deeper teaching on that. I don't have time today, but in Isaiah 8, Isaiah says that we are here, Israeli believers, we are here in Israel for signs and wonders, right? And certainly signs and wonders are beginning to take place all over the world. Messiah Jesus said these are the signs of the times, the signs of the birth pains. Yes? When I say now we can do what Paul did, what do I mean? We have this ministry blessing Israeli believers. And through blessing Israeli believers, we can give to the poor saints in Jerusalem and all over Israel. And that's exactly what we do. We have Israeli believing partners who are getting out the gospel, making disciples, helping Holocaust survivors, saving babies from abortion, all in Messiah Yeshua's name. Now, this is an exciting generation that we live in. Like none other, because it is apostolic, prophetic, and end times. You can go to blessingisraelibelievers.com. I'll talk more in the break about the details of how to participate. But what an exciting time. About 7 years ago, 8 years ago or so, I started sharing with our ministry partner and co-founder of Blessing Israeli Believers, John McTernan, about the things I had seen in the land. I would talk with Israeli believers, and they would say, oh, we're so thankful for all the financial support that comes to Israel to bless the Jewish people and to bless our nation. But so little of it comes to the believers, and we don't understand, because here's what Paul did. And they begin to show me these verses. Down through the years, they begin to show me these verses. Yes? And so I went, wow. Wow, this is amazing. Look what the Lord is doing this hour. And he began to help me understand the things that I'm sharing with you. And we started this ministry, Blessing Israeli Believers, John McTernan and I, and just sharing with a few people. And now we have ministry partners in Jerusalem. We have ministry partners in Netanya. We have ministry partners in the Golan Heights and other places, in Haifa, in the Carmel, all over the country. And we've just begun. Wouldn't it be a great way to watch, therefore, for the coming of Messiah Jesus, by walking in the footsteps of the Apostle Paul, fulfilling the responsibility of the churches and the nations to minister to the Jewish believers in Israel in material things, helping them in their time and their work here just before the coming of Messiah Jesus? We're going to break here in just a moment. And after that break, we're going to talk with an Israeli believing partner of ours with Blessing Israeli Believers. Now, this is a great way, a great way. Blessing Israeli Believers is a great way to watch, therefore, and to be ready. We'll be right back. Well, it's a windy, beautiful day in the Galilee, and I hope you're enjoying the program. And I think it's important for me to take a moment and share some kingdom opportunities that we have together. Now, first, I want to say this. If you've not yet believed in Jesus as your Savior and Messiah and Lord, please do not send any money into this program. It's our prayer that you would receive Jesus as your Savior and enjoy the program today. But for those of you who understand principles of giving and expanding the kingdom of Messiah Jesus through discipleship, like media, Watch Therefore Media is so effective. We have an opportunity to go all over the world with the Watch Therefore message, the gospel of Messiah Jesus. Also, we have our ministries blessing Israeli believers and poured out for the nations. The Bible says the gospel is to the Jew first, and then to the nations, then to the Gentiles. And so, we have our To the Jew First ministry blessing Israeli believers, and then to the nations, poured out for the nations. Now, you can find all of our ministries, Watch Therefore Media, Blessing Israeli Believers, and Poured Out for the Nations at watchtherefore.tv. You can also sign up for our monthly newsletter. For those of you who might say, well, I can't financially give, but I can pray. Oh, please do. We need prayer partners. Now, know this. We're not asking you for money. We know that our help comes from the Lord, maker of heaven and earth. And we trust Him. If He wants us to be on where you are with this program, then He will raise up faithful viewers who will partner financially with this program to keep us on the air and that will participate in our work in Israel and the nations. Now, what I'd like to do is transition to something that's also very important. We have our Watch Therefore Feast of Tabernacles Israel tour coming up in October this year. This tour is going to be so very special. Any tour to Israel is special, yet this time of year is the most special. All precious Jewish people come from all over the world to honor and to keep the Feast of Tabernacles. Also, there are born-again believers in Messiah Jesus who come from all over the world to worship and praise Messiah, Yeshua, Jesus, here in Israel. There are special celebrations in Jerusalem. We're going to go to two of those. And, it's just going to be incredible. Also, we will go all over the land of Israel, and we'll also have some of our Israeli believing partners who will meet us at different times on the tour, share their testimonies and what's going on in their lives. So listen, go to watchtherefore.tv, look at the itinerary. There's a special place on the website where you can check this out. Prayerfully consider coming on our Watch Therefore Feast of Tabernacles Israel tour. Now, we even have some precious testimonies of some of the people who came on our last tour to Israel. Oh, it was so exciting. And we trust that the one that's coming up will be even more so. Come join us in Israel, Feast of Tabernacles, this year. Don't miss it. And I'll be back with you in just a moment.
And my name is John Peake, and this is my wife, Joy. My favorite part of the trip of visiting the land of Israel with Blessing Israeli Believers and Watch Therefore Ministry was really the interactive way we dealt with all the people. The sights, the sounds, the eating, the food, the visiting of congregations and participating in the worship service and the teaching that we got all along the way. The ministry that's going on really brings the Bible to life. You're literally walking through the Bible and Bible prophecy. It's extraordinary. Never have I seen a land so beautiful and seen the supernatural regathering of a civilization that, with its language intact, its culture, its history, its currency, it's 2,000 years of Bible prophecy coming to life all at once, right in front of you. It's extraordinary.
I'm certain that the My favorite part of this tour so far has been the Jerusalem March for the Feast of Tabernacles. It went through the heart of Jerusalem, and as a teacher, my heart is for my students. And here I am in Israel, getting to lay my hands and call God's blessing upon the children of Israel, to look into their eyes, to look into the eyes of their parents. And now when I am at home and I pray for Israel, I'll be praying for its people. The people are my favorite part.
I would definitely, definitely recommend this tour for anyone, any Christian believer, and even non-believers. I think you would actually experience something that you've never experienced before.
For more information about our Israel tour this year, go to watchtherefore.tv. You don't want to miss the Watch Therefore Feast of Tabernacles Israel Tour 2017.
Well, I pray those testimonies blessed you and that we see you here in Israel on our tour. Now, as we go back to the program and think of the ministry Blessing Israeli Believers and the church's responsibility to minister to the poor saints in Jerusalem and in Israel, we have one of our Israeli believing partners as a guest on the program today, through whom we minister to the poor saints in Jerusalem. Welcome back to Watch Therefore. In the first part of our program, I shared with you from God's Word about the saints, specifically the poor saints in Jerusalem. We have a special guest on the program who's a pastor in Jerusalem. And I'm so thankful to welcome to the program Pastor Oded Shoshani.
It's a blessing to be here. Thank you.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Well, along with being a Blessing Israeli Believers partner, and we'll talk about your work in that regard as you help the poor saints in Jerusalem, and we partner together to do so. First, Oded, would you share with our viewers a little bit about what it feels like, what it's like to be a pastor in the city of the great king, Jerusalem?
I think the first thing is that most people that hear the program do not understand that in Jerusalem, in particular, also in Israel, we don't have a Christian atmosphere. We celebrate Jewish holidays. There's Jewish traditions. Usually the Jewish mindset is against the name of Yeshua. So we live in a totally different society than the Christian society. We don't celebrate Easter. It's not a national holiday. We don't celebrate Christmas. It's not a national holiday. So the first and most important for the viewers to understand is that we have a different society that we live in, a society that is not welcoming the Messiah. So I think this is the most important. And then when you live in Jerusalem, Jerusalem is the capital of Israel. Jerusalem is the hope, or the pinnacle of the hope for the return of the Lord, for the building of the third temple. So you have a lot of religious stuff going in the city. You have a lot of people from different places coming and expecting and hoping for some kind of a hope or some kind of a religious experience. So we have to deal with that in our congregations as well.
It's a completely different culture. And I think it's important
that
you raise the issue. Now, in that context, I've been to the congregation you pastor.
And you have preached in it too.
I have. And it's, what an honor.
It was a blessing.
Thank you. What an honor and a privilege. And I just want our viewers to know, we are in very special times. And that congregation, the Lord's, as you know, we say in Hebrew, I'm probably going to butcher this, but I'll try it. Avodah Tova. Good job. You're doing a good job.
Thank you.
I met real, authentic disciples of Messiah Jesus being raised up under your care. You're, of course, under the Lord's care, under your care. And there in the city of the great king,
amen.
So refreshing.
Amen.
And many young couples with young children kind of exploding there. Is it something in the water, something in the air? What is it?
I don't know, but it's a blessing of the Lord. We have, when you consider the ages 21 and under, we have more than half of our congregation these ages.
That's great.
So if you come to our service, the service is very noisy. From babies running and children running around, but it's a blessing to have children in our midst.
There's something biblical about hearing children's laughter in the streets of Jerusalem.
Amen.
Yeah?
Amen.
Yeah.
It's also biblical to hear old people's laughter as well.
Amen. Amen. That's good for us, isn't it? Well, you know, we're officially old now because the Bible says that grandchildren are a blessing.
Amen.
And the crown of old men, right?
And we are grandparents.
That's right. Well, I really want to emphasize, and I want our viewers to hear about the special work we're doing, partnering together to help the poor saints in Jerusalem. Could you share with our viewers a little bit about our work together and even specifically what you're doing in that regard in Jerusalem?
Yeshua says in Matthew 26 that we will always have the poor in our midst. And I'd like to wipe that verse out of the Bible.
Yeah,
but
yeah.
That is the reality. The Old Testament and the New Testament, they're both full of this kind of promise from God. You will always have the poor. You will always have to take care of someone who does not have the means, who does not have the self-esteem to work and earn money. So that's part of life in Israel. I think it's all over the world. But our part, we have poor in our midst. We have people who do not know how to maintain their finances. So we help in financial counseling. We have people who go through difficult periods where it's just a period and not a lifestyle. And we help those either with financial counseling or with a one-time gift or with paying some bills to help them over that bump in life so they can continue afterwards in a relatively good manner without collecting debts. Mm-hmm. And the last part is we have those who are poor, and it's a kind of a poverty that stays for a long time. One of the examples is single mothers. The system in Israel is such that when someone is a single mother, they receive support from the state. But the support and the way it's been given is maintaining the people at a very low income. Mm-hmm. So they're always poor. So we try to help these people by giving them food coupons. We help them with monetary gifts as well. But we're trying to help them a little bit above that poverty line so they can have a little bit of air to breathe financially, that we can help with the kids' education. We are doing things that usually poor people cannot help. Your gifts and your gifts to viewers as well are helping us to do that. And I can maybe tell the story of one.
Please do.
One of the mothers. We have several stories, but one of the mothers is actually someone who whose baby was saved by my wife's ministry. And
Biad Chaim, Israel Pro-Life,
amen.
Also one of our partners with Blessing Israeli Believers. It's a one-stop shop here. The pastor and his wife, she saves the babies. Pastor Oded shares the gospel. They get saved. They get discipled. It's a beautiful thing. Go ahead.
Sandy had the baby saved. And then Sandy brought that woman to the Lord.
Hallelujah.
And then this woman came up to our congregation. And she's been discipled. She's now in a home group for many years where the couple that leads that home group has adopted her as their own family.
Oh.
She receives regular support, partly from BIB, Blessing Israeli Believers. In the last year, she started working for Beit Chaim, so she's completed the circle of receiving help, saving a baby, and now she's helping others.
This is great. I hope you hear in this, you hear stewardship, not just throwing money at the problem, but making sure that is the problem. And these different categories, that tells me there's real stewardship involved in this improper management of the resources that people work hard to receive.
Amen.
And then give.
Amen.
And for that, we're very thankful.
We really try hard to have the donations that come in. We're not just giving the money out. We check the financial situation before we give help. We are making sure that money is not being thrown into a black hole, but is actually being used properly.
Absolutely. And it really is walking in that, helping the poor saints in Jerusalem. You know, any place in the world where you live in poverty is heartbreaking and difficult. Living in Israel, there's a special stress that's difficult. And then even more so in Jerusalem, it's like the bullseye of spiritual warfare in the world. And the work you're doing is so good, and we're so thankful to get to partner with it. Now, thank you for being on the program with me. As we wind down the program, I want to share with our viewers how they can participate, Oded.
And thank you for having us here.
Hallelujah.
It's a blessing to partner together.
Hallelujah. Well, you've heard this, and for anyone who's listening, who you'd say, and watching these things, and you've heard from the Lord, you can go to blessingisraelibelievers.com. That's blessingisraelibelievers.com. And that's where you can sow And a portion of the funds that come in every month go to help the poor saints in Jerusalem, just like Romans 15, 26, and 27. We see that biblical principle there. And I would say this, I say this all the time on the program. If you haven't yet received Jesus as your Savior and Lord, we're not asking for money. We're asking you to pray and receive Jesus as your Savior, your Lord, and to enjoy the program today. And He died on the cross for our sins. He was buried, and on the third day He rose again. And He offers us forgiveness of sins and a relationship with God our Father. Yes? Amen. So let's pray. And there may be somebody watching today, Pastor Oded, who needs to get saved.
Amen.
Father in heaven, in Messiah Yeshua's name, as our viewers call upon your name, whoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved, and ask for forgiveness and have a heart to repent and turn away from sins and follow you, Lord Jesus. Save them even today and forgive them. Heal, restore, and bless all of our viewers today. Thank you, Holy Father, in Messiah Jesus' name. Well, when you hear things like you've heard today that are going on in the city of the great King, know this, the day is coming when the King is coming.
Amen.
And the name of our program is Watch Therefore. So I encourage you to do that. Watch Therefore. Why? King Jesus is coming. When? Any moment He's coming in the clouds for His people. And He commands His people to be ready. God bless you.
Thank you for joining us for our program today. Our program is sponsored by the friends and partners of Watch Therefore Ministries. In future programs, we'll have many more Watch Therefore teachings from the Bible, worship, and exciting interviews with our believing partners in Israel and around the world. Please contact us at doveschwartz62@yahoo.com. That's doveschwartz62@yahoo.com. And if you would like to subscribe to our newsletter, you can fill out a contact form on the website watchtherefore.tv. We also have audio programs available on our website, watchtherefore.tv. We are on social media, since it is an amazing tool to share the gospel and communicate with one another. Feel free to also find us there at Watch Therefore Radio and TV, Watch Therefore Radio and TV. Until next time, we're watching for King Jesus to return. Watch therefore and be ready.